Hey there, my name is Wilson Wong. I'm a senior research scientist here at Carbon. Today we're comparing the impact performance of a strain rate sensitive polymer that has been 3D printed into a lattice by Carbon and comparing that to a commercially available strain rate sensitive foam. The commercial specimen we're looking at today is about 260 to 300 grams per liter. The Carbon 3D printed lattice is 220 grams per liter, which is about 15% lower in density. We'll be comparing two different impact curves. This orange one here represents an impact on the foam, and this purple curve here represents an impact on Carbon's EPU 45 FRD lattice. The important thing to note is that these were both hit with the identical impact energy of 34 joules at 3.5 meters per second with 5.5 kilos of impact mass. So looking first at the acceleration versus time curves, for the same amount of impact energy for both of these specimens, the orange curve here is much taller, much skinnier, and much sharper, which is indicative of a much harsher impact. What you typically want in an ideal curve is something that is short, fat, and with a flat top. You essentially want to flatten the curve, which results in lower peak acceleration values. And this is what you see here in this purple curve, which is the EPU 45 FRD lattice. So in other words, you're able to dissipate energy over a much longer period of time without incurring high peak Gs. And this kind of makes sense. Imagine doing a cannonball onto a concrete floor. Upon impacts, the pain you will be high, sharp, and will happen very, very quickly, similar to the shape of this orange curve here. Now imagine doing the same cannonball into a deep pile of leaves. You'll still feel a force, but that force will be spread out over a long period of time as your body slows down. So the resulting peak forces you feel on your body will be much lower. Now looking at this plot of force versus displacement, if you remember high school physics, the products of force times displacement is work done or energy with units of joules. So the area under the curves is work done or energy. A way to think about this is that both of these specimens have to displace the same amount of energy, and it is better to displace it in a way that minimizes peak force. Looking at this orange curve here, it's not able to efficiently absorb energy early on in the compression cycle, resulting in a much higher final displacement and much higher final force. In comparison to the purple EPU 45 curve here, it is much shorter, fatter, and flatter, resulting in a much lower peak force as well. In other words, the foam is completely bottoming out. It's not able to absorb energy efficiently enough early on in the compression cycle, so it is completely smushed out and all that force is just going straight to the anvil underneath. So in summary, we're able to absorb energy with 34% less peak Gs, much more efficiently, using less strain, and without incurring any densification issues. 34% lower peak Gs is not bad for a specimen that is 15% less dense and many times more breathable. This really illustrates the power of combining a strain rate sensitive polymer with a highly designed and tunable lattice structure. Other than density, you can't really design or tune the microstructure of a foam. EPU 45, on the other hand, has the highest green strength of all of Carbon's elastomers, allowing for the widest range of part shapes and lattice geometries to be printed at a high yield. I hope this gives you a more in-depth look of how EPU 45 can be a great alternative to traditional foam applications. Visit carbon3d.com to learn more about EPU 45 and our library of dual cure resins. Thanks for watching.